they charge it like 200 rand or something.
Initiation.
So this is our newest listing. It's located in Garsfontein, as most of them are. Very close to where's called Garsfontein. Great shopping centers in the area. Very easy access to most highways and byways and hospitals and all of those. So coming into the house, there's actually quite a nice entrance. But then, as soon as you walk in, there's these multiple levels. So it will not be our typical open plan property. Multiple living areas, multiple little spaces. That's why it could work as an office or to run an office from here. Great indoor-outdoor living with multiple sliding doors. There's a scullery right behind you, and then walking straight into a kitchen. A lot of the kitchen space is actually quite nice. So in the main bedroom, there's a his and hers. There's a space with a toilet. Down here, we're actually going to take out the bath and have a really cool, massive shower with a skylight. There's two more bedrooms upstairs, one bathroom, three bed, two bath, family home. It's ideal for a family, maybe even if you're working from home and need to see clients from time to time, there's an option for that as well. If you are a corporate that is looking for a space for your offices that's in a current residential house, we might be able to help you with this property.
Have a look at these 3D renders. They'll indicate how this house can be used as office space as well.
Are you well? Excellent. So we're looking for a laminate flooring. It's for my own house that I'm renovating at the moment. So it's only bedrooms, so it won't have high traffic, but I'm still looking for a quality product that will last me a good couple of years. Okay, so we were just at Flooring Depot. Very good service, and they helped us quite fast. We looked at a few ranges. There's some high traffic flooring, low traffic flooring. We're just going to use it in a bedroom, so we can use quite a low traffic flooring. It's a bit cheaper, and that was very helpful. They're carrying stock on hand, so we can load everything, get going, get it installed. That's the aim of it. It's about to get crazy. It's about to go down. So what we need here is we need those Betty 2 with the USBs.
Bauer, you know that wall with the strip light that is broken? Can you please measure for me how long that strip light must be?
So I spoke to you earlier about that strip light. Remember that cavity that we built, and we've built a recess basically with the drywall. So now I just need a light. So we've just spoken to Enzo here at High Tech Lighting. He was able to help us with the strip lighting that we needed. We're also talking about some few other things from him, possibly a industrial style fan, as well as the bedroom lights. But again, I need my wife's input on those design items. So for now, we only got the strip lights, but he gave us a really good deal on them. Worked out a lot cheaper than I expected. So that's a plus for me.
I'm gonna invest in an NVMe thumb drive. Then I'm gonna 3D print the enclosure in an NVMe thumb drive.
A few minutes later.
And this NVMe transfers.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Literally no idea.
Yeah, so this is what we do. People always think we are estate agents.
we buy
it ourselves, fix them up and sell them. So we'll wait for Petronella, who's the agent on that property, to come back to us with regards to whether there are approved plans, because plans on its own is also not worth much. It needs to be approved by local authorities and be sure that all of that is good. So right after we receive that, we might make an offer on that property as an investment. If it can be split up, like I explained, it would be ideal as a rental property. As you can probably, if you redo the flatlet to be quite nice, you can probably get about 7,000 or 8,000 rand a month of that. Add on to that the 3-bedroom house, which you'll probably get around 12, maybe 15 if it's very nice, so let's call it 13,000 rand. You're getting a rental of 20,000 rand a month, might be good. It's about to go down. It's about to get crazy.
It's gonna be loud. This one, it's quite a small duet property, and for the price, it's priced at 1,450, well, 1,499, I think, or something like that. It's probably well priced. Probably something that is accurate for the price. A small family or somebody scaling down or so might just buy it for that price. So for that reason, not really something we'd be able to add value on. Yeah, that's daily life, literally seeing stuff every day that we are not buying. We only buy one of maybe 10 or we only make an offer on maybe one of 7 or one of 10 properties that we see, and then out of that maybe one of 15 or something like that actually comes through in the end. So yeah, taking you guys along on the journey.
How's it going?
You met Ben.
Ben's filming everything we're doing at the moment.
Ben, nice to meet you.
He's our main tile supplier.
Looking for new project. That's quite cool for maybe a shower or something. About 130 square meters, light grey, not too expensive, something that's special. On the kitchen, we're probably going to do white, like shaker style doors. Thank you for your time. If you guys need tiles, up into tiling. Give us a good price on it. Tell him we sent you. Cheers. Thanks. These guys really stepped up in previous projects, gave us really good prices, and quality level of service as well, that's good. So we've had issues before where we need one bag of tile cement extra delivered to a site because we can't get to it or whatever. And Dewald gets in his Fortuner, throws a bag of cement in there and gets it delivered to site. So that's valuable for us. That's what adds value for us. So supplier relationships like this really adds value.
This is 286 Manitoba Street that I've been renovating for the past month and a half. As you would think, a job that you're doing for yourself, maybe the scope grows a bit. So we've done a bit more than planned. I don't know what you can see, and I'm going to take you for a quick tour around what we've been doing, and we're going to keep posting these updates as the weeks go by. So what we have here is we have a bit of a built-in braai area that connects the inside of the house to the outside of the house, the pool area. We've made everything one level so that it's accessible to me. And also when you open things up, you can move furniture halfway in, halfway out. It can be connected between spaces. We can have a big lounging table.
So as you can see on the videos, we have done some steel work and some proper I-beams on this project. The reason is we have long spans that we need to pass. We will also be putting a ceiling into the roof so that we can have a bit of insulation from the heat, and it gives us the capability to put some downlights in the area.
Sally by the word. 100%. Yes, thank you. Come on. We're standing at the border where history is made. We're cranking up the lights now so everyone can see. It's all happening right now. We're gonna make you believe. It's about to get crazy. It's about to go down. Ek moet vir jou sê, nommer waar ons gaan inkom is nie boe 1 miljoen. En dit is, dit sal nie vir ons sin maak, boe 1.
So we just came from a house at a lady's house. I got a call from her yesterday afternoon quite late, and I arranged to be here this morning. Didn't realize it was such a small duet, but it's a duet property on quite, with its back on quite a busy street. So because of that, driving ourselves into a dead end. Let's have a look at the properties over here as well. it's on the back of quite a busy street, and it's only a two-bed, one-bath house. The problem with those types of properties is that there's not a lot of margin available in them. And I say margin, I mean there's quite a high buy price that people buy it for, because there's like a floor to the area. And the reality of it is then that people, there's like a minimum price. So say the minimum for Garsfontein for a form of a house is like R1 million. The reality is, for that R1 million bottom, if it's a big house and I buy a very bad state big house for R1 million and I put another million into it to make it really nice, I can sell it for 2.5. The problem is with a small house like that, the ceiling on the other end is like 1.5.
Hi guys, so that was episode 1 of a day in our business life. So after each episode, we'll basically give you like a proper breakdown of what happened this week in our business. So today we're at Henny's Pretoria East. We're having a bit of a rundown of the week. We're having a beer, Friday afternoon beer time, right? That's what we do. So if you would like us to have our review of the week at your restaurant or at your pub, please do invite us. We'll come through without a problem. We'd just like to do a recording there. We'll mention you in the video. So we basically had to give a rundown of our week and what happened during the week.
So this week at the Level House, which you would have seen in the video, we basically did a bunch of demolition. Everything happened, like kitchens were demolished, floors were demolished. We also removed all the water from the pool and did a bunch of demo on the pool because we're closing up that pool. We also removed the pergola or afdak, as we would like to call it in Afrikaans, and we removed it completely. We also start demoing on the scullery. We also started most of the plaster work that we want to do inside the house. So currently there's a massive heap of rubble outside. Most of the demo is done. We aim to have that house done in about 2 months. Hopefully we'll get that done. I also looked at 2 or 3 properties. We didn't make any offers this week. We did, however, find out that a property that we sold end of last year is being submitted to council.
And we also we're taking occupation early next week. We find out that we're taking occupation early next week of a property that we're going to do as a full-on investment property. So there'll be a couple of flats at this property. What happened at your site, David?
So we've also been busy at my site. We want to take occupation end of next week. As you know, that house is for me and my wife. So there was a lot of things that happened at my site. We did the kitchen install, followed by a countertop install. We did all the ceilings, we rhino-lighted the ceilings. We did grouting on the tiles, we did skirting boards. We finished off today with the first coat on all the walls. We did laminate flooring in the bedrooms, as well as skirtings. We put in a cutting list for the wardrobe cupboards, as well as bathroom tiles that we did. I think that covers most of it. So we had a bit of a hectic week. We're planning still, I think we're still on course to finish next week. Friday we'll be moving in, me and my wife. So I think that'll be an interesting one to see if we can finish. No. But it's always like that at the end of a site.
Leroux always tells me we mustn't make too hard of a deadline on a site. This one he made a move-in deadline, so it's very much on him to do. So guys, every Wednesday we will be dropping a video like this on YouTube. We want you to subscribe to our YouTube channel, tell friends about our YouTube channel. And if you can please like this video and place a comment in the comments of this video. What you think, what we're doing, are we up to a load of rubbish or is it good? Is this valuable for you guys? That also helps us get ranked higher on the YouTube algorithm if there's comments and likes.
Okay guys, so thanks for watching. I hope to see you next week for next week's video. Cheers.